I've been making music, not for fun, mostly because it's a passion, but also because it was a priority. You know, I really had to make ends meet. Starting out as a musician wasn't easy, but I had a goal, I had a dream, I had to focus. Just as any other business, the start wasn't easy. It will never be easy for any business. But I hustled through and here I am. I see myself as a revolutionist. Trust me, it hurts that the thanks don't come. They never come. But I commercialized this business. I knew the day I won Ngoma Award that, you know, hip-hop in Zambia would never be the same. I won't even lie to you and say I was the first hip-hop artist, man. Because then I'll be disrespecting the OGs before me. You know, we had people like Master Flo, we had Crisis. Lots of people before me, Bryo. You know, those are names that can't go unmentioned. For me to say I was the start would be a lie. What I could say, though, is I made this thing sell. I don't like to think of myself as a hero because heroes achieve something. I don't think I've achieved what I want to achieve yet.
Cool. On the outside, people are asking questions about why hasn't he broken through the international market? What do you have to say about that?
Pushing is a hustle on its own. Pushing music outside is a hustle. And that, to be honest, for me, it's an issue of time. You have to be ready for a certain market, if you know what I mean. You can blow out there, and then what? Next. You have to be ready for a next step. It took me 10 years to be here. Not that I could have blown. I know artists that have blown from one song, being a number one. My growth was gradual. That's why I understand every single bit of my mistakes. I'll tell you I can't drop this song, I'll drop the other one. I'll tell you this is not a good single. I mean, that's what makes me what I am right now. That's what makes me chairman of XYZ Entertainment. Because I can tell my artists and I can scout and say this can sell. When others see a pornographer, I see a big artist.
I'm glad you've also touched the fact that you were a record label executive who's able to point out how to put out the song and how to promote it. Now, as a record label executive, you bring in artists. Sometimes those artists want to stay, sometimes they want to leave.
Yeah.
People would ask, isn't he then supposed to be happy to see his artists leave and grow and blossom somewhere else? Other than maybe say something like what you said on DJ H-Mack's song where he turned to left and, you know, you said things like, you chop off my hand.
If she ever blows.
Yeah.
Sanga, look, it's like the Bible. It's misquoted. People say different. People have different views of what the scripture says.
Yeah.
People will pick out one verse. For instance, right now you're telling me about one line. Ukanijuwe kwanja if that chick ever blow up. But did you hear the line before that? I said, I lost a lot of money just trying to promote Kantu. I lost a lot of money. I didn't make any money. It's not an issue of hating on her. Look, that's blood at the end of the day. People will be like, no, why don't you want to see? And that's the only time I've said that about someone. I'm not one of those artists who tell you how much I'm spending, what I've done. I'll tell you stuff about Kantu you never knew. You know, she shot her last video in my house. Do you know, I once spent my daughter's school fees shooting her music videos. Do you know how bad that is? You know, losing money and then someone writes you a letter saying, I'm resigning. First of all, who resigns from a contract? You terminate. And terms are, you sit down and say, dudes, let's go to the court of law. And all I asked was, can you pay us back what you owe us? But she couldn't. If I was bad, I would have taken her to court. I would have done all sorts of things. That's why I say, Ukanijuwe kwanja. I don't mean it like it's bad luck. No, I lost a lot of... I'm just trying to tell you, dude, I'm hurt. I lost so much money and time on her.
So it's just facts only.
It's facts. It's no lie. If she ever blow... I wrote Kantu's biggest single. Tell me one big... Alangizi. I wrote that. That was Bobby's song. Bobby said, I can't do this. It's a girly song. Everyone turned it down. Which record label exec do you know that writes songs for their artists? I made music for Kantu. I wrote all the songs that blew her up.
She used to be one of your artists.
Exactly.
And you've now delegated one of your artists to be CEO of your brainchild, which is XYZ. Do you trust Bobby East enough?
CEO means chief executive officer. So what it means is you do business on behalf of the company. It doesn't mean he's taking over and it's you. I mean, we still make the decisions. What the CEO does is basically scout for talent, do business, transact with the network companies, and that's exactly what Bobby East is doing. basically he's a head, and who knows, he might end up being a shareholder. So Bobby East walks in my house one day and says, "Boss," I'm like, "What's up?" "I think you need to start recording." I'm like, "Dude, who the hell are you?" He's like, "I'm your CEO."
Oh, snap.
And I was like, "I think you're right. You are my CEO. Trust me, the music we made in 2 weeks is awesome."